was it was assholes giving assholes a pass.
That's true.
Not always, but yes.
I remember World of Warcraft was like that at some point. It didn't last long, but it was like...
Yeah, it's like... If you send a toxic butthole to go see if somebody else is a toxic butthole, their threshold is their parameters are gonna... It sounds like I am lecturing people. Like, this is what you personally should be doing.
Well, I had a conversation just before where I was called to blame you. I'm like, fuck, I'm not even sister. Come on. But still, just because I said something like offset from everybody else, it's just like blame. Like, alright, whatever.
Nah, yeah. I told you that they thought you were. Or you said it was based on what you said.
I'm 41. And it's just the fact that. Okay, so. I'm 41. I love, like, I have no idea how much, but I love electronic music since 97. It is my passion, my everyday shit. I listen to it every day. Like, it's a religion, literally. Like, people don't understand. They're like, yeah, you listen to David Guetta. I'm like, no, you just don't. Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, okay. Probably good. Yeah. So yeah, no, it's all good. It's just like I've been into this music for all this time, and that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm a black sheep at work. It's just like nobody understands what I do and what I listen to and what I do. I've made music. I have an album. I have like over work on music today, but the fact is, I'm not popular. I'm not David Guetta, because I don't do shit for the popular kind of people. I do shit because I want to. Exactly. I do it because I want to, and the music that I make is not going to be popular, but it's still good. But people just don't, you know, like I'm not the type of... Exactly. It's hard.
One of the things that I'm still working on the manuscript, I actually just printed out some of the manuscripts that I'm working on yesterday. One of the things that is really frustrating that I've seen a lot of authors go through is the editing process is incredibly subjective. So like if you submit a treatment for a publishing company looks at your book, you might have a character that reminds them of the ex-boyfriend who broke their heart, and they'd be like, nope.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, so...
So you're unfortunate, right?
Yeah, so, like, the Library of Alexandria wasn't just a place for scholars, it was actually a species effort to try to educate the world of the reality of vampires and werewolves, and it was supposed to be, like, a common meeting place to try to gain information and access to the weaknesses, so other species began to pull out, and then the library was ultimately destroyed. This, of course, happened over the century, so, like, there was, an original agreement between Alexander Alexander the Great, then after upon his death, that it wasn't finished in the forge. So Ptolemy actually was the one who carried out a lot of it. Ptolemy the First was the one who carried out a lot of his orders in terms of bridging these gaps, like building bridges with these other species. Cleopatra the Seventh, who is the person that people are like, oh, Cleopatra, like every king in the Ptolemy and or in the Ptolemy line was either Ptolemy or Cleopatra.
Right.
It was everything. Like,
just like Franks in Quebec. There's so many Franks. Of course, why?
I have a question.
Sorry.
Sure.
Will your book be on Audible? Is there a possibility that this ends up on Audible?
Possibly. So I have there needs to be accessibility. You know, there are people who are blind, like, I mean, don't know Braille, or it was expensive to make. They're a lot bigger, and, you know, so audiobooks, I think, are...
I mean, I've tried, but the narrator I love the most, his name is Luke Dagger, and his books, the way he reads them, a lot of people don't like it, but it's just, the immersion is just crazy. This guy is, he won, like, awards.
Well, and you're going to make a fish emerge from it, so like you're holding the book and following along while it's being
audio. Yeah, no, the audio, I'm not like it just puts you in a trance where I'm in a car and well, I'm a different type of person. I cannot listen to the radio talking to me. My brain cannot focus on that shit and it doesn't even want to. So I can't. It has to be music playing louder or whatnot, but I just can't. So I listen to audiobooks at home while making food or whatnot.
So, and it's not like, hey, the book isn't engaging, it's like...
I actually bought the Runation book from League of Legends on both audiobooks and in real form. So I have the book and the audiobook to do both at the same time. But the thing is, the quality of it, like, they just put so much effort into all the voice actors, like, there's more than one.
But I tried many different ones, but I'm sorry I cut you, but it's just, I tried so many different, narrators, and it just doesn't work. Like, most of them are stale and just not interesting to listen to.
It's too monotonous.
Did you have to go somewhere?
I actually do, but I'm really enjoying chatting.
Yeah, no, I get it too, though.
So, but to answer, yes, I do have to go too. I'm not sure, the way that I'm using my work is really working on, and so I'm working out, tiers. I'm actually doing, an early, I'm a freelancer, business has been kind of slow since COVID, so I'm I kind of want to use my Patreon for 2 minutes now.
That's all I read.
I do have a series of comic books about a serial killer, the same universe with vampires and stuff like that. So even though his story doesn't have monsters in it, at one point you find out that his assistant, his friend, is the person who actually does have monsters. So at one point he's like, all of the victims are saying, are we dealing with a vampire? And she says, no, I checked. She's being sarcastic, but she actually took a picture of her friend and told her a vampire didn't know it. But no, and that's the thing, everything, you've got a lot of Easter eggs that make more sense, and so there are more people,
So, my books that I started with come out of books. And I discovered this matter in the damage, right? So the books are called The Iron Druid Chronicles. And those I've listened to at least 50 times. And it's just the stories.
Read to him, which I haven't done in a while, but he doesn't like reading because reading was effectively killed by him when he was in high school. And I looked at the head.
Oh, that's alright. We're playing.
We grew in reading her dumplings. I feel like when it's like, okay, 12-year-olds, let's read Shakespeare. It's reading this incredible broad archaic stuff that, you know, it's like, yes, they're classics for a reason, and it shows like the timelessness of humanity, the timelessness of certain people.
Yeah, that's a big thing.
In love